Welcome back. Now, following weeks of auditions searching for the country's best talent, eight amazing acts fought it out for two spots in next week's grand final of Ireland's Got Talent last night.
Yes, the first act through to the next Sunday's final is the amazing Fly Youth. Paul Tyrrell, Shannon Glenn and Kerry Milne have joined us this morning. But first, here's a reminder of when Lucy revealed the results.
So the act with the most votes and going straight through to next Sunday's live final is... Fly Youth. Yeah. Congratulations, Fly Youth. Well done, guys. How are we feeling? Anybody? Straight through to the final.
Oh, my God.
Well done, guys. Off you go. Tonight's winners, everybody. Put your hands together for Fly Youth. Out you go, guys.
Wow.
I love that. How are you feeling? Anybody?
Anybody? Congratulations, guys.
Thank you so much.
Well done.
Safe to say you enjoyed that moment.
Oh, my goodness.
Night.
Oh, amazing.
It was unreal.
It even comes across, it comes through the television. The buzz is unbelievable. But what's it like standing there for that 10 seconds waiting to hear?
Just
torturous.
Because it is a long 10 seconds, isn't it?
Yeah, literally. Definitely.
And there's like a bass and all, and it's like so tense in the room. Literally, you could hear a pin drop.
Yeah. I think it must be tricky because you've just gotten the best news of your lives. You're through. And yet, you've got these other two contestants on the stage. One of them, the little boy, Aidan. And my heart was going out to him. So I think there's a fine line between celebrating, isn't there, and being sympathetic to the people who are left standing there. Yeah. So it's a tricky balance.
Absolutely. Yeah, definitely.
Kerry, that routine last night, in terms of, because we've spoken to various acts over the weeks, and of course we spoke to Zach after you got through the first rounds, preparing for that routine last night, when does that start?
Actually, like, we were super, super prepared. It was something that we put a lot of thought into for quite a while. I came home, I was away, and I came home for the midterm. We kind of blitzed the whole thing out, so we had the kind of concept in our head. But I just think we wanted to bring a different kind of energy. We wanted to show like a different side of the kids and kind of bring that fight. It was kind of like based around the idea of them being their own superheroes. Mm. So kind of like embracing their power, embracing their strength and bringing that to the stage to really fight for a place in the final.
It always fascinates me how it goes from a concept.
Yeah.
We have an idea and then to actually turn it into choreography.
Right.
And then to teach it.
Yeah.
And then to drill it. Mm-hmm. And then to polish it. Mm-hmm. Like, it's not a short process, is
Absolutely.
It?
Absolutely, no. I mean, we train the kids. I think a lot of it is to do with how they're learning and their mindset they're in.
Yeah.
So that's what we do, develop a lot of, like, strengthening their mindset so that when it comes to a preparation like that, they kind of are ready to be pushed. But I don't think they've ever stepped up the way they stepped up for this process.
So, Kerry, this is a dance school, just to put it into perspective for viewers at home, that's run by yourself and Zach, who's your brother, of course, Zach Milne, who viewers will be familiar with from last year.
Absolutely.
And from our chats this year as well.
Absolutely.
So you're based in Glasnevin, but
correct.
Shannon, you're from where?
Belfast.
So how do you wind up in a dance crew in Glasnevin?
Well, they were known, like, they're amazing and everybody in Ireland knows. So, like, the teachers are amazing and just the vibe that the studio had. And I just always wanted to be a part of that.
So in your dance circles, everyone would know about these guys?
Yeah, okay. Definitely.
Brilliant. So what does it mean to be part of a school like that and now this happen?
Yeah.
It's just like a dream come true because, like, people from Belfast, I know that they would love to be in my position.
Mm. Mm.
So it just feels so unreal that I'm actually lucky enough to be here and...
And the kids all learn differently as well. When you're talking about, Kerry, about teaching the kids, and you know, they all learn at different speeds, you
absolutely.
Know, and in different ways. So to get them all up to that level, to be right for the night, for the performance, takes a lot of work.
It does. And I mean, there's a wide age range.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
they're all very different, but I think that's something that we kind of try to use as our strength, like. Their individuality, like, maybe some of them are better, like, just you give them kind of an idea and let them run with it. Some of them need, like, that, like, to be told exactly what to do. They're all very different, but I think we've kind of have kind of gelled them together over time. So
course,
we've luckily enough got to a point
planning
where
now starts for the final.
Yeah.
That's it.
Paul, I gather you're one of the, because I've met you and we've talked out there at the Helix during filming sessions behind the scenes and stuff. I gather Paul is one of your kind of stalwarts in terms of keeping the crew together and guiding some of the younger ones, maybe?
Absolutely, yeah. And he, actually, Paul, like, I'll never forget when we met Paul. He used to, like, he just arrived at the studio about maybe three years ago. He just came, he started taking Zach's class. Oh, sorry. And every time, every week you'd see him. We'd see him once a week, and then a few weeks later he was coming every night. And just his development over a very short time and his passion was very evident from the get-go. And he just naturally has taken a leadership role within the crew. Yeah. Amongst, like, a lot of them have really stepped up over the last few weeks. Just to help each other, because I think, like, sometimes instead of waiting on us, it's nice for them to have people within their group to go, let's go, guys, let's get it together.
But that helps hugely, like, for you, like, to have that passion, to enjoy what you're doing, because it's a serious amount of work, rehearsing 5-6 nights for a routine like that.
Yeah, but it doesn't feel like work when you love it that
much. See, this is the thing.
Yeah. And would you train, let's say, park the show for a moment, just generally, would you train every night?
In the studio, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Most nights, I'd be in the studio.
So it's a massive commitment.
It is, yeah.
So it's all been leading to something like this, really, for you, has it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everything. And, of course, himself then, Zach. Where's he off to today?
He's in Barcelona
today. Of course he is, yeah.
So
what's he doing over there now?
He's teaching
classes. Whose videos are going to pop up in
that? He's teaching over there today, so he has three classes, so that'll be, like, 90 minutes each. So he hopped on at 6 this morning and
he'll be back
rearranged. He's back he was back tomorrow, but we've adjusted the situation.
Is it straight into the studio tomorrow? Start rehearsals?
Today?
Yeah.
From here.
Kerry, give them an hour to enjoy it.
He's a slave driver.
It's a great show to
How
put
many
on.
Is in the troupe altogether? That we've
23,
we've seen on
23 that we have on stage.
And is there lovely camaraderie amongst you all?
Yeah.
We're all good buddies.
Yeah, we're all the best of friends.
I think that's very genuine, isn't it?
Well, listen, the best of luck for the final.
You've been great entertainment so far.
And we're excited to see what you're going to bring to the final.
Absolutely. Fingers crossed, guys.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Now, after the break, gorgeous looks for mothers of all ages. Stay with us for fashion next.